A new report finds a jump last month in the initiation of foreclosures. Default notices were up 33% in August from July's level.
A big part of the reason that we're seeing this spike in August is that we've had artificial delays for the last 9 months because of robo-signing and other paperwork and procedural problems. The fact that we're starting to see these foreclosures enter the system indicates that perhaps a lot of the backlog is starting to move into the system, and we're past some of these paperwork problems.
Many of the nation's largest banks reacted to those problems by temporarily ceasing all foreclosures, refiling previous cases, and revisiting pending ones. Despite the sharp increase from July, the data show last month's total of nearly 79,000 notices was still down 18% versus August last year and 44% below the peak set in April 2009. Actual repossessions totaled nearly 65,000 last month. That's down 32% from a year earlier and is the smallest amount in 6 months. But the spike in initiation proceedings could have a silver lining in it for the troubled housing industry.
Ironically, as odd as it seems to say that a 33% increase in default notices is good news, it actually sort of is from a housing market perspective. The numbers we're looking at right now are sort of baked in. We've known there are 3.5 to 4 million seriously delinquent loans that should have been in foreclosure already. This is the first wave of those that's actually starting to hit.
Five states accounted for more than half of all foreclosure activity in August, led by California and Florida. Nevada still leads the nation, with one in every 118 households receiving a foreclosure-related notice last month. Mark Hamrick, Associated Press.